Hello and welcome back to another Satisfactory guide. I'm TotalXclipse and today we're going to be looking at Satisfactory's fluid mechanics since the 3.6 fluid update. Now this guide will cover all the basics as well as a huge amount, if not all, of the advanced functions that I can possibly think of. We have over 4 pages of script to get through, so it's going to be a long one. In fact, we're probably going to put this into 2 videos, so do bear that in mind. I will also have timestamps below so that you can skip to the parts that you feel you need. I do mention that we go into a lot of detail, so do bear that in mind. Anyway, let's jump into it. First of all, liquids are unlocked with coal power in Tier 3, first with water and then later on to other fluids such as crude oil, fuel and sulfuric acid. In order to use these resources, we will need to make use of piping. So let's go on to pipe basics. In Satisfactory, we have 2 types of pipe available, the Mark 1, which can transport 300 cubic meters of liquid per minute, and later on the Mark 2, transporting a total of 600 cubic meters of liquid. Pipes are connected directly to the output of a source, such as an extractor, or to the liquid inputs or outputs on a packager or refinery. When transporting liquids, the pipe has a flow indicator that will show the type of liquid transported. This will be shown by the color of the pipe, and it will also undulate according to which way it's flowing. We can also see from afar how full a pipe is by looking at how widely spaced the undulating pipe is. If it's open to its full extent, the pipe is full, and if it is partly open, it is only partly full. It is also really important to note that you can check the amount of liquid and flow rate of a pipe by clicking on the said pipe, and if you wish, you can empty a pipe by pulling this lever to flush it or to flush the whole pipe network that this pipe is connected to. When it comes to placing a pipeline, you can click an input or output and then drag the pipe to the location. As with conveyors, you can also make 90 degree turns by placing a pipe support 2 places in front and then 2 to the side. Now with the pipes, we can also change the placement style of the pipe. We have 3 options available to us: the default, vertical and noodle. Now my preferred option is the vertical, as it gives 90 degree corners at the joints, whereas noodle and default seem to have a more sloped approach. Advanced piping. At this point we're going to explain how to create an overflow system with the use of pipes. Now with pipes it is possible to create this by using an upward U-bend in the pipe. This works by prioritizing lower pipes to fill up before it pushes above the bend. That way, if liquids in the pipes prior to the bend are being consumed, liquid will not push up over the bend. However, if you do choose to use fluid buffers at this point, the head lift of the pipe is equaled between the buffers, which will cause water to pass over the U-bend eventually. Now, we can counter this by placing unpowered pumps in the early game, facing into the buffer. This stops the water backflowing, and later on, once you've unlocked them, you can actually use valves, which are super useful as they can limit the priority pipe to a certain flow capacity, allowing you to overflow excess liquid into the U-bend pipe. I then wanted to show off a general example of a coal generator system and how you'd pipe it. For this demonstration, we're going to be using coal generators, and this is a simple setup which should make early game fluids easier for you. The golden ratio, without talking about overclocking or underclocking, is 3 water extractors to 8 coal generators. We can merge the 3 extractors to a pipe using a pipe joint, either by placing the joint on the pipe or by placing the joint first and connecting it with the pipes. However, if we were to do this here, we will not be using the extractors efficiently, And later on, we'll find that this coal generator system cannot run according to its efficiency or max capacity. So each water extractor produces 120 cubic meters of water per minute, with a maximum flow rate of 300 per minute in a single Mark 1 pipe. So for this, we will need to use at least two pipes. And in this example, we will actually use three. Here we will run this setup by feeding the middle generators with the middle extractor's water, and then from either end we will connect the other two extractors. This allows us to consume the water in the machines along the manifold so that at no point does the water produced exceed the maximum flow rate of a single pipe. Note that I have decorated the setup and I've placed pipes through foundations. However, to do this, you must have placed the foundations down first and then placed the pipelines. I should also mention for this setup, you will need 120 coal on a Mark II belt. And as a note on generators, they do scale fuel consumption with required power, so this will only use all of the fuel when your factory hits its peak power requirements. But that actually sums us up for part one of this two-part coverage of fluids. So if you did find this video helpful, please do drop a thumbs up. And obviously, if you want to see more, don't forget to check me out over on Twitch or subscribe to me on here. Now, in the next episode, we will actually be talking about headlift and other more advanced systems about overcoming height with a liquid. So do make sure to check that out. Anyway, guys, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. And also, special thanks does go to all of our supporters on this channel, but most notably, our TotalXclipse patrons, The Calamity, Tommy Ostgaard, and Bo Papa, as well as our Lunar Eclipse subscriber, Matt Lippard, as well as our Blood Moon of the Day, which is Jimmy Rogers. Anyway, guys, until next time, as always, ciao for now.